every single shot that we do takes a lot of preparation, days and days of preparation before you actually get it before the camera. David Tremont, for instance, spent a good few weeks building this beautiful mansion that we knew was going to be blown up in seconds.
The most exciting thing has to be the mansion exploding.
The initial stages is sitting down with the directors, designers, whomever, and getting out of their head what they see, what they imagine it to be, what sort of explosion, how big we can make the model.
It has to be built specifically so that it destructs in a certain way. You don't want the model to just kind of go like that. You want bits of it flying off. You want debris flying towards the camera. You know, that's a huge staple of Thunderbirds, explosions, little things flying away towards the camera.
You've got to build it extremely fragile, as there's a lot more technology, as it were, goes into making something to come apart.
And when we put the trees in, it looked fantastic. And people, when we mentioned, hey, look at this, isn't it beautiful, would be appalled when we said, it's going to be blown up, it's not going to exist next week.
I get this a lot. I've built many pyro models over the years, and that first reaction is always, you don't want to see your model destroyed. But no, completely opposite to that. A pyro model is purpose-built to be destroyed. That's the whole challenge of the project.
When we're trying to recreate the kinds of explosions that Derek Meddings and his team produced for the original Thunderbirds, again, there's a very specific look to them, often because they were using quite dangerous things.
Numerous chemicals they were using were carcinogenic, which we can't use now, but those chemicals produce very specific sort of looks. You know, black smoke turns up everywhere in Thunderbirds when there's an explosion. There's usually this toxic stuff which you wouldn't want to breathe in, and you can't use now because it's illegal. One of the challenges for our pyrotechnicians was to go away, look at what they were doing, and then try and come up with something that was the equivalent of what they were using so that we could achieve the same sort of look.
It requires working a lot with the pyrotechnicians, you know, designing what sort of explosion, what sort of sequences, how many, how big.
That's the larger charge that we would suspend in a roof to blow the roof off and the timbers. And then we have others here which will fire vertically in the air, producing flame at the same time.
The pyro guys come in, put all their charges into it. Then once they're all finished, they move out, then I go in and fill it every gap I can with debris.
You know, Tremont spent weeks and weeks building this model, and it's all in one shot. It's going to blow up, and if it doesn't work, we can't do it again.
So we actually put two cameras on it just in case to make sure that we got it, because we'd never be able to set that up again.
You just hope that it works.
So when it exploded, it just went pow.
If you were to come into the studio and watch us shooting the special effects, to be honest, it all looks a bit rinky-dink. When we set off an explosion, it's not a huge fireball, it's and it's gone.
One.
And that's why shooting at high speed is very important.
You're shooting at a higher frame rate than normal film. Normal film runs at 24 frames per second, so in 1 second, you get 24 separate images that are taken by the camera. High-speed photography, you could be doing, you know, for our explosion shots, we did 120 frames per second. So it's a lot of pictures in that 1 second, and then you play that back at 24 frames per second, and everything happens really slowly.
Tiny little becomes. And that applies to the models as well. When you've got models on strings flying across the screen, they tend to bump and wobble. If you shoot it at high speed, and then when you play it back normally, the bumps and wobbles become sort of, you know, gentle turbulence. It just feels right. The craft have weight. They feel like they're actually suspended in midair.